Before we begin building projects, I'm going to go over a list of prerequisites and dependencies that we will use in this series. There's a few different things that we'll need, so let's jump right in. First, let's talk about what you'll need to know before beginning your development journey on Casper. Number one is an understanding of Rust or assembly script. On Casper, smart contracts are stored and executed as WebAssembly binaries. If you want to write smart contracts on Casper, you'll need to write them in a language like Rust or assembly script so they can be compiled down to WebAssembly. In this series, we will mainly use Rust to write our smart contracts, but don't worry if you don't have much experience, as we'll start small. Number two is an understanding of JavaScript. Technically, this is not necessary to build dApps on Casper, as we support SDKs for multiple other languages. But since JavaScript is very often used to build Web3 applications, this is what we'll focus on most. Additionally, for building web interfaces, we'll be using React, so if you're familiar with React, that will help you considerably. Third is a basic understanding of blockchain fundamentals. To be able to follow along with these tutorials, it'll be important to understand the fundamentals of blockchain technology. There are great resources on Casper's website, casper.network, for learning more about the basics of blockchain. So if you're unfamiliar with the technology, you may want to do some prior research first. I also very much recommend following along on a Unix-based operating system like Linux or macOS. If you are on Windows, you may still follow along using the Windows Subsystem for Linux, or WSL. I'll link to this in the description. Next, let's discuss and install our dependencies. To be able to communicate with validators, and thereby the blockchain, you'll need a node client. This can come in multiple forms, like client-side SDKs or command-line tools. First off, you'll need Rust and the Rust Casper client. This is a command-line tool that will allow you to submit queries and deploys to live nodes. To install Rust, head to rustlang.org and click Install. If you're on macOS or Linux, you may simply copy the rustup install script and paste it and enter it in a command line. Now, I already have Rust, so I will click 3 to cancel the installation. Once you have Rust installed, we can install the Casper client. We'll use Cargo for this. Cargo is a Rust package manager that comes bundled with Rust. To install Casper client, run cargo install Casper client. This will take a minute to complete, but once it's done, this is what your output should look like. To verify that it installed correctly, you can run Casper client dash uppercase V. And if you get a version number, you know it installed correctly. Next, we'll need Node.js. Our application will utilize Node.js as a runtime environment. If you're not familiar with Node.js, it allows you to execute JavaScript outside of the browser using Google's V8 engine run locally. To install Node.js, head to nodejs.org and install the LTS version. The Casper.js SDK does support Node version 18, but we will use the LTS version for future compatibility. Once you open and install the package, you can head over to a terminal and run node-v to verify that the installation worked correctly. Note that if your terminal was open when you installed Node, you may need to restart it for the changes to take effect. Lastly, you'll need an IDE, or an Integrated Development Environment. For this series, I'll be using VS Code. To install VS Code, head over to code.visualstudio.com and click Download in the upper right-hand corner. Next, just click Download and install for your operating system. Note that you may use any text editor or IDE. This is just what I'll be using for this series. That's all you'll need for now, and with these tools, we'll build some pretty great projects. Remember to like and subscribe if you found this information useful. And if you'd like to be notified when new videos are released, click the bell icon below. I'll see you in the next video.